I'm zombie but awake, 밤비가 내려와. Can't wait, no time is a game, so I just put it on my way. I'm zombie but awake, 밤비가 내려와.
What is good, my crazies? Yes, y'all, welcome back to the lab. Lee here in the seat, man. Y'all saw the title too as well. We're just gonna have a cloudy thought, a cloudy mind, and chill out, and to actually ask you for questions for me so we can do a Q&A. Yes, leave those questions down below. But before we get moving into this video, I wanna give a big shout out to Moneybags. Big ups to him for actually throwing a big shout out for me, showing him on in that last video he made about Dumb and Dumber in the hat. Big shout out to him. I love Moneybags. With that said too, also check out this channel too. I'm showing you right here, Mr. Eugene Green. He does the Mandela Effects too as well, but he does it in such a different way that will open your mind to understanding the messages in between him. Every Mandela Effect has a message. I believe, like he believes, that there are messages that are being told from a higher power, maybe whatever. There are messages behind these Mandela Effects, and he breaks it down for you with the movies and stuff. It is amazing. Kind of got the idea with that messages from the, in the Mandela messages or messages on your mind, the Despicable Me thing, and kind of got that idea from that. But what he does is just on a different level. We all do different things differently, our own thing differently. He does what he does awesomely. He brings a kind of the spiritual religion aspect to these Mandela Effects. So check out UG Green. Shout out to him. Give him a big shout out when you go over there. Tell him I said I sent you, as well as Benjit, man. You will get hooked on how these messages kind of connect and how together the timeline he does. I don't want to give anything away. He does it in a great way. Everybody has their quirks and their little niches in how we do things, and that's a great one, man. That is, I couldn't do it the way he did it. He does it great. So check out Eugene Green. That's all I sent you. With that, big cheers. But also with that, big cheers to y'all, man. 720, 26, 27. I'm saying it now, but it's going to change here quickly. And it is amazing, man. I feel like every other video I make, I'm giving you a shout out. Hey, man, we just hit 600, but we just blew up and went 120 more. So 7 something, man. Big shout out to you. This is y'all's channel, man. Y'all are doing great. Y'all are wonderful. Hit for y'all. Gorilla Goo, by the way. Then next, oh man, this is going to be a busy kind of 2 weeks for myself. As you saw my little message yesterday, a little rough day with mom yesterday. Everything's fine, but you know, it's going to be a little different week this week. Maybe one or two videos, because I really haven't, I got it all in the book, but I haven't sat down and done anything, just because I got family things going on. With that too, next week I'm going to have my daughter, so it's going to be kind of almost a little quiet week there too as well next week, the 27th through the 1st, but I do expect to make a video with my daughter, with my child. If you haven't seen the last one, it was our little dad and daughter adventure day. We went to Fun Spot, and it was fun. It was great. We had a blast. We recorded that, and it, you can check it out. But I'll probably end up doing something else like that too with her. That's my baby, man. That's my child. I love her to death. I can't wait to have her here and have some fun. It'd be a great escape from a lot of the things and my personal life that's going on, you know, personal life with everything in the family. And it'd be a nice little kind of getaway to just to clear the mind and just enjoy and be a kid, you know, enjoy being a kid, because we grow up, we forget to be a kid, you know, we forget to have fun and this life these days. Look over there, my cat is doing something crazy. He's being nosy. But yes, we all do so. I do want to ask y'all questions. I want you to ask me questions so we can sit down, do a Q&A. Please leave all those questions down below, down there, so I can go back to this and write those questions down and be able to get those questions too as well. Man, crazy, ain't it? Crazy, crazy, crazy year so far. A crazy, just, it's going to be fun, man. It's a crazy time. Summertime's around, first day of summer. Amazing. Mom is hoping, we're going to figure out what's going on with mom this week. She's got her mental health evaluation, so that is going to kind of give me a bigger picture, a broader picture of what eventually I'm going to have to do anyway. With that too said as well, I gotta go back to work eventually. I'm becoming broke. I do want to do this. I want to do this full time and make videos and do what I do, because, you know, if I had the time and I was making money through this at the moment, I could probably pull out 2-3 videos a day, probably 2 videos a day. But I could, you know, I'm edit myself. I do my videos. People always ask me, how do I, you know, how do you get all this? How do you do this so fast? It's something I put my mind to, I guess. I write it down, get what I need to do. I know what I want to talk about. It just gets down. And I think kind of sometimes these harder, these videos right here, just being normal, or normal anyways, but just chilling and talking, smoking with you, this is the mental rambling mind. It's a little different too. It's like, oh man, am I keeping y'all here too long and shit like that? But now, but I just wrote it down, and I figure, you know, I want to do this full time. I want to be able to do this full time, just as of right now, because I want to keep my mom here before I have to put her away. And not put her away sounds so bad, but put her in a place where they can actually take care of her fully. That's going to have to happen eventually. But either way, but if I could do, if I had the complete time and the money, and, you know, I would put 100% of that. I put 100% of it anyway, but man, it would, I wouldn't know what would happen. It's crazy. Oh man, I'm trying to think of things. I got high over here, and I'm a little tired. If you hear it in my voice, I had a comment I read the other day. I'm thinking of some comments I read that blow my mind. I had a comment the other day about, you know, how he appreciates how I do these Mandela effects, kind of the way I talk about it, and he brought up, hell, I don't even fucking remember no more. Mr. Dawson, I don't know what it meant. Old dude, I remember watching him back in the day, the conspiracy theories and stuff like that. And, you know, he's talking about how he was talking about the multiverse and Mandela effects and stuff like that. And I liked how he does it. I think he's now part of the system. But anyway, I don't know. I'm trying to think of it. I can't think of shit, but that's how it was. I just wanted to really come here and just chill with y'all, say thank you, man. And, you know, it's, man, without y'all, this wouldn't be it. But man, without y'all, I probably wouldn't have the sanity that I have right now. I wouldn't have a smile on my face just because of everything that's going on in my life at the moment. And but what doesn't kill you make you stronger, that's for sure. I do want to answer kind of one question. I know it's probably going to be answered again, but everybody asks me, and one of the big things they always ask me is, what was my biggest Mandela effect that got me into the Mandela effect or made me notice? And I'm trying to think of like the most specific one that just startled me and shocked me. But definitely Forrest Gump, you know, life is like a box of chocolates, it really was. And then Darth Vader, because I'm a big Star Wars fan, you know, definitely bursting theirs. But man, I think I'm like a lot of other people that think about this, and they think about Sinbad and damn Shazam and that damn genie movie. I'm not talking about Shaq's Kazam. You know, I think it's really that, you know, because it blows my mind away, because I remember going, we lived in Italy or Germany at the time, and I remember renting that movie and watching it with my mom. And it is so weird. It's crazy. I think that's probably the big, maybe the one that got me kind of questioning what it is. Y'all know I do psychedelics and stuff like that, but that woke me up a little bit more, you know, seeing it. I was like, man, so I did my research, and then I've been nonstop just blown up about them. I enjoy them. I do. I used to be so shocked about them. I do still get shocked about certain ones. And definitely the new ones that weird me out a little bit. But it is an amazing awake tool, I should say. You know, the truth always comes out in between the lies. And it is very amazing to see just how that works and how it's working. And like I said, when you watch Eugene Green's channel, and kind of get the spiritual part of it too, it resonates even more. And it's crazy. It is really wild to think about. Yeah, I think I rambled along enough. I don't know. Maybe I haven't smoked enough yet. I don't know. I do know if you live in Florida or anywhere in this South. I know the whole world's hot. It has been a hot summer, bitch. They're gonna cook us. They are cooking. Oh, brain blast. What was I watching the other day? I can't remember what I was watching the other day, but I saw the map of the USA, or the world map, the regular map, not the globe, but the map. And I was looking at it, and I was looking at the states, and it was so weird how it was like Florida was disappearing, like it was underwater or something. A lot of it was. It just looked so weird. The new map, it was weird. I wish I could remember what it is. I'll come back in a video and probably remember what it is, but man, I can't remember what it was. But it was so weird. It was like, wow. It was like New York was gone, Maine was gone, Florida was totally gone, except like two little dots. It was probably Disney World and damn little Everglades. But it was weird. It kind of blew my mind a little bit. With that too as well, I was rewatching Ghostbusters the other day, and the new Ghostbusters, and that movie itself is a complete Mandela catalog. I'm going to have to do a video on that, but it is a complete Mandela catalog. It basically almost shows every inch of Mandela effects in theirs, the big ones, small ones, even theirs. And it's really weird. It's hard to explain, but now that I watch a lot of movies now, especially the newer movies, you go back and you watch new ones from past, maybe from 2007, maybe you can go back to 2013, and you watch these movies and you see it, even the older movies, and you see these kind of things standing out in the Mandela effect stuff, and it is so odd, it's so weird, a little bit eerie, but kind of like, I get it, but it is crazy, and it wakes me up. It's fun. But other than that, I just wanted to do a video to kind of say hi, thank you for everybody, give those shout outs for you, ask for questions for a Q&A so we can come back and do one, and kind of give you an insight, kind of what's going to be happening within the next 2 weeks, because it's going to be a busy next 2 weeks for myself, and going to be working on a video probably tomorrow. I'm relaxing today. I had a rough day yesterday. I got back to everybody's comments, so big shout out for y'all, for y'all's patience. But I had a rough day yesterday, a long, long day yesterday. So I just wanted to throw this out, tell you what's going to happen. Probably a Mandela Effect video later on this week. Probably also with, I'm not sure what I want to do. I have a subliminal message one too. I got stuck in my mind. And I also have probably some glitches or some kind of fun one somewhere. And then next week is going to be in my child. So. We're going to see what happens there. I'm going to play that one by ear. But with that, man, love y'all to death. Big shout out to you, man. Big loves to everybody out there. Just showing love to everybody around the tube, especially in the community. And with that too, man, y'all remember to keep your mind open, because those eyes will see everything in front of them. You best believe it. Y'all stay crazy.
Hang up this phone, and then I'm going to show these people what you don't want them to see. I'm going to show them a world without you. A world without rules and controls, without borders or boundaries. A world where anything is possible. Where we go from there is a choice I leave to you.